Good morning, good morning. We'll be beginning shortly, so if everyone could get ready to take their seats. Good morning. Good morning, FSS Tigers. Welcome to the Faculty of Social Sciences orientation. How are you feeling today? Excited? Tired? All of the above? Yes, no, maybe so. That's all right. Well, today we're going to have a very informative session to get you guys ready and warmed up for this new faculty. My name is Nathan Walker. I am the president of the Honor Society, which is the cadre of students who exemplified academic excellence. I'm hoping to see many of you in the future. And today, I will be your host for the proceedings. And today marks an important step in your academic journey. You see, when you step on this vibrant campus, you're not just joining a university. You're joining a diverse community full of intellectual vitality, curiosity, resilience. And you know, you all worked very hard to come here with determination, and now you're about to start your UE dreams. Give yourself a round of applause. Yes, so it's my pleasure to welcome you all here today, and I'll be welcoming you, including the Dean, Dr. Heather Ricketts. Give her a round of applause. As well as Deputy Dean, Dr. Christine Clark. The Associate Deans, Heads of Department. We have our FSS Rep, Perry Cummings. And additionally, we have lecturers, staff members, presenters, sponsors, and most importantly, our VIPs. You all, give yourself a round of applause. So our first speaker will be the illustrious Dr. Heather Ricketts, Dean of the Faculty of Social Sciences. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Dr. Ricketts to the podium.
Thank you very much, Nathan. Good morning. On behalf of the entire Faculty of Social Sciences, it's my pleasure to warmly welcome you into the family. This is the FSS family, and we welcome you. We are the home of the Tigers. You would have heard Nathan say so. The Tiger is very focused, also determined and resilient. And we are a very focused, determined, resilient faculty. And we will be your new academic home for the next 3 or 4 years, if you're part-time. We're happy that you chose the UWI and you chose our faculty. We know the challenges that COVID-19 brought, and so we celebrate your resilience and your success in matriculating to the UWI. You made it, and you're here. Give yourselves a round of applause. As every good Caribbean family does, we always give a very special welcome to our visitors. And so I must single out our foreign or international students for special recognition. Are there any international students here? If you are, please stand and let us know where you're from. I saw a hand go up, lady in the yellow blouse. Where are you from? Please tell us. Barbados in the house. Welcome. Young lady in black. Guyana, wow, welcome. Trinidad and Tobago, welcome. Trinidad and Tobago, welcome. So we have Barbados, Guyana, and Trinidad and Tobago. Anybody else? Oh, I'm so sorry. Cayman Islands, welcome. Special, special welcome to all of you. I'm not sure whether many of you know that your enrollment this year has historical significance. The journey that you are beginning coincides with the UWE's celebration of its 75th anniversary under the theme Rooted, Ready, and Rising. As you would imagine, the celebration of 75 years means the celebration of a very rich legacy, one that you will be building upon with your own academic journey. As an institution, we are firmly rooted, recognized as one of the enduring and outstanding regional institutions, and positioned among the top 1% of universities in Latin America and the Caribbean, and the top 1.5% of universities in the world. Like the wider UWE, our FSS brand carries a reputation of excellence. However, in our case, cultivated over 6 decades rather than 7.5. So we began teaching in the Faculty of Social Sciences in 1961. We have very outstanding faculty, lecturers who are at the top of their disciplines, and many who are known and recognized for their work, both nationally and internationally, and there I include regionally. So we are very ready for you, and I hope that you are ready for us. For those of you who are seeing the campus for the very first time, I'm sure that you're already appreciating its vastness and its scenic beauty. Isn't the view of the mountains divine? Have you all looked at the mountains from where you are? Anybody got a chance yet? Yes, I see hands going up. Have you explored the tranquil Chapel Gardens? Anybody went to the chapel yet? Chapel Gardens? Not yet. The expansive layout will mean that you'll get lots of exercise navigating the various spaces. So if you come from Preston or Rex, you know that you're going to have a lot of walking to do. Have you gone to the bowl? How many of you saw the Usain Bolt running track? Couple of you, yes. So we encourage you to explore. To echo the deputy principal in his welcome speech last week, unlock your inner explorer. University life is vibrant, dynamic, and enriching, and there are myriad opportunities for your growth, development, and even your transformation. I'm sure that the Guild representative, Mr. Cummings, will be able to tell you this as you interact with him over the course of the year. Our Faculty of Social Sciences mirrors this vibrancy and energy, and we trust that you will enjoy your journey with us. So seize the opportunities. Let me allay your fears, any fears that you might have, beginning as a freshman student. Some of you are the first in your families to go to university. Some of you have had to leave home, and for the first time. At the parents and family orientation last week, Wednesday, I had the privilege of speaking with two such parents, one from Montego Bay and the other from Negril, both happy for their sons and their daughters' progression to UWE, but a bit emotional about them leaving home and anxious about them starting this new chapter and also having to navigate Kingston. And I'm sure for some of you, perhaps having to navigate Kingston might be a little bit or giving you anxiety. But we'll take care of you. We promise collectively that we will do our best to ensure that all of you would have one of the best experiences of your lives and we will allay your fears and the fears of your parents. Some of you might be unsure that you made the right decision in terms of your degree selection. We're here to guide you, and we're prepared meticulously to support you and to alleviate any anxiety. We're committed to ensuring that you feel confident in your decision to join the Faculty of Social Sciences. For the remainder of this week, we have organized sessions in your respective departments where you will meet the leadership, the administrative teams, and the lecturers, and where we will help you successfully register for your courses. Importantly, too, we have arranged academic advising sessions, which are critical for answering any questions that you might have about your career decisions and anything else that is UE-related that you might have questions about. So we are advising you to attend these sessions. You may also visit the orientation page on our FSS website, where you will find the orientation schedule under the additional resources section. You're about to begin an exciting intellectual journey that is designed to help you to achieve your career goals. It'll expand your minds, stretch you, as university courses and programs are designed to do, shape your perspectives, provide you with opportunities, and give you space to think and also to dream. Speaking at Boston University's 2018 student orientation, one of the presenters reminded the students of the following about university. And he said, "A culture of inquiry is the culture into which you are entering. You have gotten here in part by becoming excellent at answering questions. We're now asking you to learn to ask questions, to explore possible answers, to ask more questions, and perhaps hardest of all, to hold off on the impulse to supply quick answers, to learn to live in the suspense of not knowing." That's really what university is about. As much as our Faculty of Social Sciences will be your home for the next few years, we encourage you to explore other faculties and their programs. You might discover unexpected passions and avenues for personal and intellectual growth, and also other exciting career options. Your UE Mona journey doesn't have to be centered in one faculty. So if, for example, you have an interest in cultural studies, but you're studying marketing, you could think of using your program's electives to pursue those interests once you are qualified. That's just one example I'm giving. Whatever you do, we encourage you to do it well. You can make it onto the faculty's dean's list or be inducted into the Honor Society. Nathan is currently the president of that Honor Society. And you get onto that with a strong GPA, grade point average. And such strong performances have the potential to open doors for scholarships, for internships, and also to make you eligible to participate in study abroad programs, and even eligible to become the faculty valedictorian at graduation. Balance is, however, important. It cannot only be about academics. You'll meet new people, you'll make new friends, you'll discover new accents, new cultures, new possibilities. So get involved in student life. Join a club or a society. Join the guild. Give service. Engage in activities for your own personal growth and development. And make sure that you have fun. If you live on hall, get involved in hall life. We want you to be rounded and to thrive. Possessing multiple attributes is a quality that has become much more sought after in this increasingly competitive labor market. The UE has articulated that its ideal graduate should possess a particular set of attributes which would make him or her a standout. And these attributes are as follows: be a critical and creative thinker, an effective communicator with good interpersonal skills, and make sure you take that critical reading and writing course very seriously. That's Found 1013 or Found 1019. Whichever one you are taking, make sure that you dedicate time to completing all assignments. Continuing with the attributes, IT skilled and information literate, innovative and entrepreneurial, globally aware and well-rounded in your regional identity. Many of you don't quite know the region, and so we want you to know your region. And also another attribute is to be socially, culturally, and environmentally responsible. And you do that really through the clubs and the societies and your general civic engagement. And the last is to be guided by strong ethical values, which is extremely critical. The faculty generally hosts a variety of conferences, seminars, talks, symposia, dealing with myriad topics and issues. These are generally open to all students, so we urge you to look out for announcements on Mona Messaging. That will be our communication medium, or from your lecturers, and to try and attend a few, including some that might initially pique your interest. You just never know where the light bulb will go off, where or when. Remember that university is the opportunity of a lifetime, so don't squander it. In most developing countries like ours, the majority of the population never make it to university, either because they can't matriculate or because they cannot afford. I imagine that quite a number of you sitting here are financing your education, or perhaps you're doing it through a student loan, and you would therefore know firsthand the sacrifices to be able to afford this level of education. So let me leave 5 tips with you. Align yourselves with the people who are serious. Practice good time management. Try not to procrastinate. Carve out a few hours per day to course reading, practice, and assignments. Focus on your race, not somebody else's race, your race. And lastly, but by no means not important, act responsibly and take responsibility for yourselves and your actions. Make sure that you read the handbook, know your program, know the UE and the faculty's regulations, read your course outlines, paying attention to the course objectives and also the learning outcomes, and take advantage of the study resources on campus. Please, I'm going to ask you to guard your mental health and well-being. They are critical to your success. If you begin to feel overwhelmed, talk to somebody. Seek help. Head over to the health center. Speak with a program coordinator, or tell a friend in confidence, or speak with your lecturer or one of your administrators in the department. And don't let anybody downplay how you say you are feeling or make you feel uncomfortable about expressing how you are feeling. So as I close, I want to share the message of the deputy principal to incoming students like yourselves at last week's parents and family orientation at Mona. Do your best. Stay the course. Take care of yourselves. Focus on your race. This is not a competition. And as the Guild president reminded us, the UE Mona student mantra is, each one, help one. Remember, as I said at the beginning, you're not merely students joining an institution. You're inheritors of a rich legacy, pioneers of your own stories, and contributors to the ongoing narrative of the UE and the Faculty of Social Sciences. Embrace the challenges and the opportunities that lie ahead, knowing that you're part of something much larger than yourselves. Thank you again, and welcome to the Faculty of Social Sciences. Before I take my seat, permit me to introduce the faculty's leadership team, and I will start with the Deputy Dean, Dr. Christine Clark. Heads of departments, Dr. Patrice Whiteley, head of the Department of Economics. Head of the Department of Government, Professor Suzette Horton. Head of Department of Sociology, Psychology, and Social Work, Dr. Herbert Gale. Executive Director of the Mona School of Business and Management, Dr. David McBean. I'm not sure whether other colleagues are here, but Dr. Holger Henke, the Director of the Sir Arthur Lewis Institute of Social and Economic Studies, that's a graduate institute. If he were here, I would introduce him, but that's a place to consider for those of you who may be considering programs such as development, policy, economic development, that is, and social policy. And we also have Senator Dr. Floyd Morris, who is director of the Center for Disability Studies. He's actually on assignment in Switzerland with the UN Agency for Persons with Disabilities. I want to introduce to you as well the associate deans. I don't yet see Dr. Carol James. In fact, I think she's traveling. But we have an associate dean for undergraduate studies and student experience, Dr. Carol James. I guess you will meet her on another occasion. Dr. Kavita Johnson, associate dean for partnerships and resource mobilization. If Dr. Tracy McFarlane is here, I'm not sure if she's here, but she's the associate dean for graduate studies and research. I also want to introduce you to our senior administrative officer in the faculty office, Ms. Stephanie Pinnock, standing to the back of the room. And our entire team of administrators, wherever you are, can you just wave your hand, all admin team. Our professional staff and our service staff, wherever you are, just raise your hand, please. I see Mrs. Sherman Howell. Yes, I see the team. Thank you. The team of lecturers, can you all just stand if possible? All of you who are here. Thank you very much. And last, but by no means least, our Faculty of Social Sciences Guild representative, Mr. Perry Cummings, who you will hear from. Rousing applause for Perry. So, students, we will be your new family on this, your new journey. Welcome again to the Faculty of Social Sciences. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that amazing and warm welcome. Okay, now, I hope you all were listening, guys. We're going to have a spot prize. So, I have a small token for the first person who can come and answer this question. I hope you're listening to our amazing dean. The question is, this year, the UWE is celebrating an important anniversary. What anniversary is UWE celebrating, and what is the theme for this year's celebration? Anyone? First person. It's a two-part question. Ready. Okay.
I'll say it into the mic.
So they're celebrating their 75th anniversary. And
wait, one more time. Go on.
So they're celebrating their 75th anniversary, and the theme is Ready and Rising.
That is correct. Give her a round of applause. Good job. Okay. So, before we go to our next presenter, we need to sprinkle a bit of information. So, our new students, did you know that the Mona campus was the first UWE campus? The Mona campus welcomed the first group of undergraduate students, there were 33 medical students, in 1948. So the Faculty of Social Sciences was later established in 1960. So yeah, fun fact. Now, we will be going to our next presenter, which is the distinguished Dr. Christine Clark, the Deputy Dean in the Faculty of Social Sciences, whose presentation is titled An Overview of the UWE Rules and Regulations. So please listen carefully and take notes as Dr. Clark shares important information that will help you stay on track while completing your degree. And you need to listen because we're going to have two more spot prizes throughout the rest of the session. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Dr. Clark to the podium.
Good morning, Tigers, and welcome again to the Faculty of Social Sciences. We are certainly happy to see you all here this year with us for orientation, and a special welcome to those who are watching online. We are very sad that you're not here, but we hope that you will engage with the process, ask the questions that you have, and we'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. So welcome again, and it's very heartwarming to see you all here. I see quite a few of you in orange, so I think you all got the message before. Yes, FSS's colors is orange and or black, so you did a good job there. As the dean indicated, we do have five departments that teach at the undergraduate level. And I want you to all know, you all belong somewhere. Your major is not just hanging out there somewhere in the cloud. Right, you're actually belonging to a department within the faculty. Is there anybody here who does not know what their major is? You know you're a UWE student, but you don't know why, what you're going to study, what's your major? Anybody here doesn't know? So everybody knows their major, correct? Is anybody here majoring in physics? No? Anybody here doing public policy and management? Some hands going up. Good. Right, you're in the right place. Anybody here for math? Excellent. So you know your major. So you need to know this week, what department do you belong to? So that when they ask you which department are you in, you're not to say social sciences. That's your faculty. Your major is in a department, and there are departments that make up the faculty. So your first port of call is your department. The administrators there, almost all of them, have more than double digits experience at UWE. There are very few new people who don't know anything about UWE. So that means any question you have, you should first start at the department. Don't call your aunt who was here 25 years ago, or your friend from the district who just graduated. Come to your department first for whatever questions, issues, challenges. You can no longer study here, you need to take a break. Your department is the first place. There are some things that we at the faculty office will have to help you with, but you should first go to your department, get official advice. Thank you very much. So, what are the departments? And I hope you're seeing on the screen. We have the Department of Economics, the Department of Psychology, Sociology, and Social Work. We have the Center for Disability Studies. Some of you will take some of their courses as electives. The Department of Government and the Mona School of Business and Management. So having named the names of the departments, is anybody here still not sure where they should go for orientation for the rest of this week? Anybody doing a major and you can't identify just from the names? Because I'd love to tell you, because you absolutely have to go to orientation for the rest of this week. It's very important. Okay, don't come with what you remember from high school and think it will automatically roll over. The dean told you when UWE began, right? Totally different from what you may have seen or experienced at your high school. So it's very important you plug in immediately. For those of you who are just coming, and for those of you who were in high school, quite a time back, you can imagine, right? You need to plug into what UWE is about, the UWE regulations, which I will do my best to give you what you need right now, because there's a lot more that I can tell you today, but you're going to zone out in about 15 minutes. So who else is here with you? Imagine this is not the entire faculty, right? The numbers I have on the screen give you an idea of just who is coming this year. Just this year. So there are students in second year and third year. There are students also in our graduate programs that you will come across as you navigate through. And this is why we are here, because we are committed to your success. That's one of the planks of our incoming principal. Student success is central to what we're doing in the faculty and the departments. And so we are trying to orient you throughout this week as to what it is you're expected to do for the remaining 3 years. So all of you are here, I believe. There may be a few who are doing a diploma course, but you're here to read for a degree. And I emphasize read. I'm sure since you've been here, you haven't heard any bells ringing to tell you that it's the start of orientation or the school day. And there's no PA system that will remind you fees are due, meet the bus at this place. No. You are going to have to read emails, course outlines, course material, read on your own. You see a program you want to apply to, you will have to read about it to know what you need to do and by when and get it all done. So our degrees here are 90 credits. So we talk about credits and we talk about courses. You need at least 90 credits to graduate. Each of our credits in this faculty, each of our courses in this faculty contain, generally speaking, 3 credits. So if you do the math, you're doing about 30 courses over your entire degree. And if you're full-time, you're here for 3 years, ideally, that means you're doing about 30 credits per year. Each semester, that breaks down to 5 courses, 15 credits. Remember, we do not operate on a term system, right? Not like high school. We have Christmas term, Easter term, summer term. No. We're doing semesters. We have 2 semesters. Those are mandatory, i.e. the university expects you to be here. Semester 1, which classes begin on Monday coming, September 4, and semester 2, which begins in January and ends sometime either sometime in April. So we don't have 3 terms. We have 2 semesters. So if you're full-time, you're doing 15 credits, semester 1, 15 semester 2, that's your 30, you repeat that year 2, year 3, you have 90. That's your bachelor's degree. Now the degree you want to know the answer to. First thing is, I am part-time, but I want to be full-time. Anybody here like that? Or can I, right? So again, the handbook tells you what are the priorities or the criteria that you need to meet in order to make that change. However, I know some of you, you would have done maybe some additional CAPE study subjects and the grades just came out, but you got your offer letter, let's say in June or July. For those of you who were successful in CAPE since, you can go to admissions and ask for them to have your case reconsidered, if that is your scenario. Otherwise, you will have to acquire 24 of the 90 credits I mentioned, which is roughly 8 courses, before you can apply to change to full-time. So I hope that answers your question. And then the other thing is, in terms of the majors, can I change my major now, right? So I came in for X, can I do Y instead? There are some of you who, unfortunately, that's not going to work because perhaps you didn't get the grade in CSEC that we need you to get to enter into the program that you prefer. So unfortunately, you're going to have to stay in the major that you chose from the options that were given to you and complete it as best as you can. For others of you, later on in the academic year, the portal will be open. And what we want to do, we encourage you to what we call double major. So right now you're in one major, you can add another, or eventually you can think about adding a minor or 2. Later on, we'll tell you how you decide which one to add and how you go about adding it correctly. Okay? So that's the major and the minor. So that's later on in the year. So again, is there anybody who knows what my Mona is? Anybody can tell me? Ever heard of my Mona? Right, so this is the problem. So we've been talking to you in my Mona since August 1, and nobody here has received what we've said. My Mona is your UE email. We're not necessarily going to email you at your personal email, hotgirlnumber1@yahoo.com. No. All of you have been assigned a UE email. That is how UE will keep in contact with you. You'll get all the notices there. All the advertisements are there. You will know what is happening if you pay attention to it. It's easy to log in. Anybody here has registered yet? Although you shouldn't have, but you have. So the same place you went to register, that landing page where you click to go into the student administrative system, that is where you go to log into your email. It's my Mona. You use the same login information that you had used to register, or i.e. your ID number and the password associated, you get into your email. Please, today, before you leave campus, if you're commuting, before you go back to your hall, if you're on hall, log into your My Mona and check out all that we've been saying to you. So we've spoken about the foreign language policy. Another reason, again, why you can't take academic advice about your program from someone who's already graduated or even still here. Because the Faculty of Social Sciences is this year implementing the UE's foreign language policy, which has implications for your level one courses that you will take. Is there anyone here who has done CSEC Spanish or French? Anybody? Good. Excellent. And you passed it. Thank you very much, Dean. And you've passed. You took the exam and you passed it. You've gotten your grade and you know you passed it. Okay. So listen carefully now. The foreign language policy, as you heard the attributes of the Mona graduate, right? The UE graduate, actually. The goal here is to try and ensure that each student who graduates has some familiarity with a foreign language. So in your handbook for your major, depending on what it is, this doesn't apply to IR majors, international relations, or tourism management. You will see that we've inserted there, where it wouldn't have been in previous years, the foreign language. And these are the courses that will satisfy that requirement. If, though, you have already passed either CSEC Spanish or French, or CAPE Spanish or French, you have the option of applying for an exemption from these foreign language courses. Okay, so this is why you need to pay attention. How do you apply for that exemption? We're gonna have a session to talk about that. So remember, you're gonna check your My Mona for the alert for the session that will take you through that process. Just bear that in mind. You're gonna get a checklist from your department. These are the courses you need to do. Put an asterisk beside this foreign language course, and you're going to come to the session. Okay? So, what is it like studying at UE? In this faculty, what we have are lectures, two-hour lectures. Some of you may have an hour here and hour there of the lecture. Some persons would have, you know, a two-hour block, and even others may have a three-hour block. So our lectures and tutorials add up to 3 hours. However, they are designed based on the course. And then there's also what we call office hours. All three are critical to your academic success. You cannot do only one and be successful. It's not possible. All three. So that means when you log into your My Mona, you're gonna also have access to a calendar. Or if you use Gmail, you prefer that one, you're gonna schedule in the lecture time, the tutorial time that you have selected, and the lecturer's office hour, which will be told to you for each of the courses. So let's say you're a full-time student. The lecture and tutorials add up to about 25 hours because you're doing 5 courses, 3 hours per course, and then you have the office hours. Oops, sorry, I didn't know it was touch screen. And then you're going to schedule around that your other personal study time. Because if you're full-time, if you're working full-time, how many hours minimum would you work? If you had a full-time job somewhere? 4? Oh, 40, right. So if you're a full-time student, it stands to reason that you're going to work in your work 40 hours. You're going to study at least for 40 hours because that's why you're full-time. Same way you're going to work it out for your part-time. So the point is you're going to schedule in your calendar. So every day you have an agenda of work that must be completed. Because you're on a journey. The semester doesn't begin on November 30. So nobody should be saying, oh my goodness, I didn't know I had... No. We're starting next week. So you know from now, you need to know. Schedule everything. If you schedule it, it will come up, then your job is to get it done. We're on a journey each semester. If you treat it that way, you will be able to tick off and say you have accomplished what you were to accomplish in each course, because that's the only way you get through the degree. Okay? So we're on a journey. Some of you, as I indicated, for the foreign language policy, you're going to have to apply for some exemptions. Some of you have some other capped subjects which are listed in our handbook that you can also use to apply for an exemption. So there are some nuances to the registration. Each of you will have a different journey also. So don't say, well, my friend got this, I didn't get it. Did you have the CAPE subject to get it? It's not automatic, okay? You have to select the proper combination of courses as listed in the handbook. Right now, we do not have a special degree or a special major where you can, you know, choose the combination. No, it doesn't work that way. Your degree has some core courses, must be done. Then you have some choice. That is where you add the major and the minor. We're going to talk about that, you know, later on in this semester. You have to select the proper combination. Some people at the end of 3 years, they have too many level ones, not enough level two, threes. Some people have just enough level two, threes, not enough level one. What do you think happened to them? They cannot graduate. Right? The program is specified. You have to follow it and stay within those parameters. It's not just about what you want. Yes, that's part of it. We'll accommodate you with the major and the minor, but not just a random selection of courses. So you're going to check your email. And then you should have heard about OURVLE, that's our learning platform. Your course outline should be posted there. Office hours, some of you may do tests on OURVLE and you'll see your grade and all of that. You have to log into that every day, particularly for those of you who are commuting from very far distances. Notices may be posted on OURVLE about a class being rescheduled, moved to another room, moved online for some emergency reason or otherwise. You have to log in every day. This is just going to be part of your process of keeping in touch and keeping up to date. And of course, in order to graduate, you will need to be successful in all the courses. Okay? You have to tick off all of those boxes. So what else is there? The dean mentioned some of these. We have several clubs in FSS that you are more than invited to join. And if none of our clubs appeal to you, you certainly are free to start your own club, okay? You can also volunteer. No matter how, quote unquote, bad you think your situation is, I can guarantee you, even in your own class, there are persons who would love to get your help and your support in any way, whether it's just emotional, whether it's, where do I go for help in a particular area? You can also receive an award for students who do very well in particular subjects. You can receive awards. You can go on exchange. You can do study abroad. You can get a scholarship to do graduate work or to do some kind of research with a lecturer. We also have summer school. Remember I mentioned 2 semesters. We do have summer school, but it's not mandatory. It comes at an additional cost to your tuition. So do not sign up for summer school unless you're confident 100% that you can pay that additional fee. Okay? I know some of you have already heard about, and maybe this is why you're here at UWE, the Work and Travel Program. We know that you will be trying to navigate that area. Please be minded. We expect you back for the first day of class, okay? Lots of students get into lots of trouble because they come back after mid-semesters. We're not gonna give you your own mid-semester. It's not going to happen, okay? It's just the reality. So we know you face realities, but we also have a system here, and those are the realities there. So make sure you come back on time. And in all that you're doing, it's very important, as the dean indicated, to make connections. I can't see that any of you having, even during your period, will not need a recommendation from a lecturer. So it's not enough you're in SSLT and you're always at the back hiding, you know, you have a big hat on or a big wrap and nobody knows who you are. It's going to be hard for you to navigate the academic space and even your job space without these academic recommendations. And I can tell you, my colleagues, the only way they're giving you a recommendation is if they know you. They've seen you, they've interacted with you, so no matter how shy you are, let the lecturer know who you are. There's office hours, so if you don't want to speak up in class, you can always engage with the lecturer in office hours in tutorials, which are smaller, more compact, and designed to help you work through problems, questions, and engage with the lecturer. And I see on our agenda, we have the health center coming. It's very important that you take the time to ensure that you are okay. Do not do exams if you're unwell. If you're sick, you're sick. You need to go to a doctor, get a medical certificate, go to the health center if it's while you're on campus. Okay? We have these mechanisms, use them. You will have to pay your miscellaneous fees. It's all included. How do you know you're on the right track? Okay, this is orientation, so you're with it today, but life happens, we know. It's going to happen. Remember, my Mona email, you have to keep up. Go through it. Select out the things that are critical, add them to your calendar, and clean up your box. Keep up with it. Follow the FSS on all social media platforms. I'm sure you're already doing that, but I had to put that on the slide. Get on Instagram, whatever it is. Follow the FSS handles. That's one way that we used to communicate with you. There's more information than I could describe on our website. It has been redesigned, reorganized. Everything is collated, hopefully along the lines that you want to navigate it. We're going to have QR codes up all over, and please leave us your feedback. Went to this office today, got awesome help. Big up the administrator. Let us know what is happening as you engage with the faculty and the university. The handbook, the 2023-24 handbook, is your Bible for FSS. That's what determines where you go. Please follow it, stay with it, stay close to your department. As I said, all our administrators, maybe if we add it up, they way exceed the 75 years of you, their years of experience. Please consult with them. Always get academic advising and follow official advice. So as life happens, we know that there are going to be challenges. To the best extent that you can, we hope you can plan ahead before the things that we maybe are not so happy with happen, but we can't plan everything. So what happens? What should you do? What do you think you should do if for some reason you just, let's just say you're here and you're thinking, you know, I can't actually come to you. I'm here because I got in, I got my letter, I was invited to orientation, but the reality is I can't get in. Can't continue. I can't come next week. Don't just leave your record hanging. That's the most important thing. There are mechanisms to deal with it. So if you're here, for example, and you know you can't start next week, go to admissions and indicate that to them. What if you start classes and you start doing the assignments and something happens and you realize you cannot complete the semester? You cannot just not come. You have to engage with the system. If you've done assignments, you've started your academic record. And so you need to close it as best as possible. As I said, we're going to have more sessions because I can't tell you all the processes. Click here, click there, type. No, I can't tell you this now. Suffice it to say, you must go to the department and they will advise you as to what to do by when. In your MyMona email, the campus registrar has already given you all the deadlines as far as it relates to tuition, adding courses, dropping courses. If you need a payment plan, all of that has already been shared with you. So you need to adhere to these deadlines as best as possible, as well as the methodologies to do. The methodologies to do it. But in essence, you will have to use the online systems from the student SAS in order to say to UA, I am no longer coming, I'm on leave of absence, or I'm totally withdrawing from this program. We are now in the normal registration period. This is the time for you to explore, to read the handbook. It tells you for each course what this course is about. This is the time now. The deadline for dropping courses without penalty, I think, is September 16. Please hardwire that here. After that, you will be fined. You will have to pay. Okay? So you have to get that document with the deadlines and put them in your calendar. Put every single one if you're still unsure. Generally speaking, you are able to do this up to the first 3 weeks of the semester. After that, it's fines, okay? And there are deadlines. And there are deadlines beyond which you won't be able to drop and you will still have to pay for the course, okay? So please look out for the emails, and I believe that one has already been sent. So what if you miss an exam? At this point, there are two reasons why we can excuse you from an exam. You were unwell, as I said. If you're unwell, you cannot do an exam. At least it should not, or is not likely to be, a reflection of what you can do. You must get a medical certificate. The lecturers, myself, I don't know if the dean, but I know for myself, we cannot get you into an exam. Our duties stop at the point where the lecturer sends the exam to the examination department. That's where our power ends. Similarly, we can't take you out on an exam. So if you come to us and say, oh, we cannot get you in to the exam, you have to pay up those fees. And there'll be somebody here to talk to you about how do you navigate that system. No one can get you in, okay? They're gonna swipe your ID card. If you're not cleared, that's it. So we have to plan what we're doing and meet the deadlines to get it. So if you have the doctor certificate, it's routed through the health center, and eventually you'll be able to do an examination only. So you'd have had your coursework grade, you will go in and now at the next offering, do the exam, and then we'll bring the grades together and give you your final grade for that course. Or some of you might be sportsmen, sportswomen, you may be doing some national duty. Once we get that letter from the association or the body, then we will make arrangements for you. And I'm only emphasizing the last paragraph because I know some of you would have heard, oh, you can get an oral, oh, you can. That is only for students who do a course in their final year and they fail it with a grade of 45 during that year. So you can't get a 45 when you're a first year, not retake that course and expect to get an oral for that same grade in your final year. No. Only for courses done in the final year with a grade of 45. And only for two. Some of you may know about the GPA system. That is what UWE uses to codify the quality of your degree at the end. So yes, you're gonna get a numerical grade. Yes, you're gonna get a letter grade, whether A plus or B minus. I know no FSS Tiger is gonna go below that. So I won't talk about it in the ranking. But we do have some students whose GPA falls below 2. In the first instance, the first semester that happens, you're placed on academic warning. If that happens for a second consecutive semester, you will be required to withdraw from the university. have to tell you, because even though I know no one here that will happen to, it's important that you pay attention to the GPA. It's based on the quality of your grade. So yes, you can get a C, but that won't change your GPA. It will essentially flatline. And a C here, we're talking about 50. So if that is corresponding to the 2.0. If you fall below that, you need to go to your department. You have to go to your department to see what can be done from the first semester that happens. What do you need to do? Where were you going wrong? What did you not do? Did you do the lectures? Did you go to tutorials? Did you do office hours? How were you preparing and what it is that happened? The departments usually will opine on these RTWs. You can apply for a waiver, but the best thing is don't allow your GPA to be below 2. That's the best thing. So we don't have to fix it, okay? Some of you, a small number, I think, may want to transfer faculties. You may want to study in our weekend program, which we have, which is 3 of the majors that are offered in the regular day school, quote unquote. We offer it on Saturdays. Because some of you may have to work, you may be taking care of siblings, you're unable to get the time to come to classes, remember, part-time at UWE does not mean evening, okay? It just means you're doing 3 courses. So the classes can be, even if you're part-time, at 8 a.m. or 11 a.m., okay? So for some of you, it may be more convenient for you to come on the weekend, and that's fine. You can come in our weekend program. We just had our orientation on Saturday. For some of you, your job might post you in Runaway Bay or, you know, Negril, and so our Western Jamaica campus may be more convenient for you. We can facilitate that. You apply through the admissions portal. The same place you went to apply to come, that is where you apply to transfer to the other faculties. So who do you contact? If you have a problem with your course, coursework, lecturer, tutor, you start by contacting the lecturer. If you email me, I will simply have to go right back down to the lecturer to find out what, if any, they know about it. So it's important you start with the lecturer, then all the programs have a coordinator. So if you're doing econ, there's a coordinator. In fact, we have level coordinators as well. There is somebody who should be able to respond to your challenges. And then this is posted on our website. Eventually, if it needs to be escalated because you haven't gotten a response within 72 hours, then you can eventually escalate it all the way up. If you are thinking about doing an exchange, you will have to interact with the faculty office or studying abroad or even the requests for examination only, which I mentioned before. You will have to interact with us in the faculty office, and I put a picture of our door and, of course, our mascot. We can't go anywhere without him. You will need those approvals to be done at the faculty office level. So I encourage you, as you walk around this week, you know, explore as the dean suggested. And this is our view. I'm not sure how many of you came from the parking lot. This is our faculty. We're here to support your faculty plant. We're here to support you. As we said, it's all about student success. And so I want to wish you a very productive week, finding out about your program, finding out about the different questions you might have. Some of you might be thinking, I have an override. She never said anything about that. I can't tell you everything today. I'm so sorry. But the department and its administrators and HODs will be there to welcome you. Please ensure that you attend all of the sessions that are designated on the orientation schedule for you and ask your questions. Read, ask questions, come back and ask more questions, okay? We're happy to hear your questions. I leave with you the front view of the landing page for our website. You can email me at fssdepdean@uemona.edu.jm if you have any challenges. And remember to check your My Mona email for all the announcements. Remember, there's not going to be a bell or a PA system reminding you today's the last day to X or Y. You have to read, you have to keep up with the announcements. I see a hand. I don't know if the chair will allow me to acknowledge the hand. Can I? Okay, go ahead. See if I can hear you. That one? Okay, so she just wants to take a picture. No problem. Thank you again. Thanks for the attention. And as I said, you can certainly email me if you have any questions. However, I'm channeling you to the departments because, as I said, combined, they probably have multiple years of experience beyond even you's age that they can help you. Oh, I see another hand here. Okay. That's the one you want? All right. Thank you.
And just a reminder, we're being live streamed by the wonderful UE MonaMedia. So if you have any questions or you're doubtful about the presentation, you can go back to YouTube and you'll be able to see it. But yes, so thank you once again, Dr. Clark, for such useful information. I hope you all paid keen attention because your deputy dean just saved you like 2 weeks of emails back and forth. So once again, thank you, Dr. Clark, for such amazing information. Give a round of applause. So next we have a very vibesy speaker to address you all, a man of faith and passion that I'm sure many of you already met him and his team. He is the FSS representative on the UE Mona Guild of Students for the academic year 2023 to 2024, and he will be extending a welcome on behalf of them and entertaining us with our very own private gospel concert. So FSS Tigers, I want you all to help to let me hear you roar as we welcome Mr. Perry Cummings Jr.
No. All right, could you please just turn down the microphone for a little bit? Good morning, everybody. Wanna sound hungry? Oh my God! Good morning, Taylor.
Good morning.
All right. Any other hall in here today? I saw somebody from who is that? I saw Preston. I see somebody from Preston here. Big up on yourself. At the faculty level, it doesn't really matter what hall you're from. We're all SOSAI students because I see some person standing at the back. Big up on yourself. Big up on yourself. I mean, at the faculty level, it doesn't really matter what hall you're from. We're all SOSAI students. I just want to say welcome to the Faculty of Social Sciences. First of all, I just want to greet Dr. Ricketts, our dean, deputy dean. Big up yourself, Nathan, president of the Honor Society. Could you just give a round of applause for all of them that is here? Administration, big up on yourself. I want to just say that everybody came here for a degree. That's the priority. And everybody, once you do what is required of you, you will get your degree. So don't reserve from helping each other because there's a degree here for everybody. Help each other out. Big up to everybody who came in their orange shirt. There's a special something for all those who got the memo, who wear them orange shirt. Big up on yourself. So for right now, I just want to say welcome. Some of my team members are here. They're scattered across the room, but I do have members from the Guild Committee for the FSS this academic year. You'll meet them. See them always. All right, just so stand up now. And raise your hand. That is awesome. Put your hands together for us. Yes, you'll meet them officially coming soon. I wonder if I could just do a little something before I hand over this microphone. Should I? I don't know. Should I, FSS? Can I do a little something? Sound man, you have the track ready? But play it with me here if it's the right track. The other one. The other one. Because people just wake up, so vibes up the place. But could you turn it up for me, please? So for this, more everybody just stand up. Just stretch your legs. Pull it up. Come now, man, FSS, we vibrant, man. Now make me I don't have things. Guess what go on now? Every hall have them chant, but FSS have a chant. And again, when it comes to faculty, it doesn't really matter which hall you come from. So guess what? Catch it. Hey, I miss a one suicide, one suicide, one. I miss a one suicide, one suicide, one. Over here, one suicide, one suicide, one. In the middle, one suicide, one suicide, one. Listen. When you see the orange and the white, the snow say the wall are so side and bright. All them a go on like say I just hype. And we in a the library, I study all night. Side tech, you made a fool style them bite. But they know say we full of vibes, the vibes will ignite. Anywhere we go, you know the flames ignite. Everybody just sing, alright. Everybody say, one suicide, one suicide, one. No sound hungry. One suicide, one suicide, one. Hey, I'm for one suicide, one suicide, one. One last time, one suicide, one suicide, one. Dr. Ricketts. Remember, a pretty girl said she saw the econ. She just want a suicide man. So we stood because we have midterm exam. Be a vibes bill, guess what? And if she in a suicide, me, I buy her lashes and bag. Lashes and bag, and buy her lashes and bag. If she in a suicide, me, buy her lashes and bag. Lash. One last time, catch it. Hey, I miss a one suicide, one suicide, one. I miss a one suicide, one suicide, one. One last time, one suicide, one suicide, one. Hey, I miss a one suicide, one suicide, one. Putting the hands together, big up on yourself, big up on yourself. All right. So as you can see, the Faculty of Social Sciences is a very vibrant one, right? And we have a lot of plans for you this academic year. I believe Dr. Ricketts made it pellucidly clear that it's not just about academics, but we want to give you a wholesome experience. So, Soci Mingle is the 21st of September. This is where you'll come and gather, meet somebody, network, and also get a little refreshments, yeah? So that is coming up. We plan to have our annual Soci Week that is coming up. Look out for it. And we'll be having our flagship event coming up, which is Miss Soci. I'm not sure if you've ever heard of it, but it's a very big and bashy event. And I'm already seeing some nice FSS ladies in the congregation today. So I'm expecting a lot of submissions for the Miss Soci pageant. We also will be having a lot of new initiatives, so just stay tuned. If you see me on the campus, feel free to ask questions. There is a chain of command. I'll not be able to answer everything, but I am the bridge between you and administration. I've been answering some late night calls, helping you guys with some things. My committee members as well, big up on yourself, putting the hands together for the reps, because me know no knowing at the WhatsApp group. Una ask questions, and even though sometimes them talk a lot for real. Yes, that's true. But we especially the one group there. But guess what? We've been engaging you as much as possible, but this is your official academic advisory, and I want you guys to make the best of it. For now, big up on yourself. One source. All right, bye-bye.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that was your FSS representative, Perry Cummings, Perry in Christ. So you see that Sosa is not a little Fenke Fenke faculty. We are faculty of vibes, right? Right? All right. Okay. So we all know how important it is to take care of our mental health, especially with studying for this degree. You is not a very easy thing, and you know it's going to be a rough, rough journey. But our next speaker is Dr. Tina Hilton Kong, Clinical Director of the UA Health Center, who'll be telling us about the services offered at the University Health Center. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Dr. Hilton Kong to the podium.
Hi, good morning, thank you. I had a little PowerPoint, but it's okay. In the interest of time, I can go ahead. Can you hear me? Okay, it didn't sound so vibes. Yeah, I have to say, can you hear me? Okay, because I want you to be vibesy, and I want you to stay vibesy throughout your time here at the UE, because we want to make you well, keep you well, so that you are giving your best effort towards your academic, okay? So the health center is located right on Gibraltar Camp Ray, across from Social Welfare Training Center where you go and eat sometimes. Anybody have bought food there? It's right across there. It's up by Irving Gate on that road that goes, the road that goes from Irving Gate right down to the post office. You know there's a post office? Okay. They'll soon know, but it's that long road from Irving Gate to the post office, and the health center is right there, so it is projecting. Okay, it's projecting. All right, great. So our beautiful campus, and we have the health center. Are you able to see? Are you seeing my presentation? Not yet? Okay. So we are committed to promoting wellness. Many times we have to be end up making you well, but we want to also promote wellness. So are you able to see yet? Okay, so that's the health center across from Social Welfare Training Center. We're open 8:30 to 4:30, Monday to Friday. So unfortunately, we can't open on Saturdays, we can't open in the evenings just yet until we are able to in terms of resources. We can be contacted by an extension if you're on campus, 2270 or 2370, or any of our lines there, 927-2520, 970-0017. I would ask for you to be patient. When people Google and cannot get through to UWE Hospital, the next place on the Google is our health center number. It says UWE Health Center. They don't see anything but UWE University. And so a good percentage of our calls are people trying to get through to the hospital. So it's not that we're sitting on the line busy. So I just ask you to urge for patience. We are trying to sort that out. I'm told that they can't do anything about that, but we're trying. There's an email if you have to send any reports and so on. Or if you can't get through on the phone and you'd like to make an appointment, we may be able to allow that. Health Serves, HEALTHSERVS, we don't spell with an E, at uemona.edu.jm. But you can make an appointment via the phone or come in to see the receptionist. So there we are in that area. Up from Wexnettleford, we're kind of, you know, a bit central if you consider the whole campus. And we offer these services, nursing services, medical consultation. We have a general dental clinic. Our pharmacy is open to not only students and staff and retirees and their dependents. It's also open to the community. So persons from the health center down further come to us. Persons from outside come to us. It is pretty stuck. I know we had a rough time and people were saying they can't get stuff. We've made a big change, and so you can get things there. And we have some over-the-counter things as well. And there's public health and health education and, of course, our counseling services. So you need your ID card and your health card to come. If you haven't got your health card, once you have your ID, and you have paid up your miscellaneous fees, you can access the services free. If you haven't paid up your miscellaneous fees, then you have to pay the charge, okay? The services for seeing the doctor and so on is free to the students by swiping your card. If you're going to use a pharmacy, then it's a co-payment. So you have to look at the SagiCore when you get it. Please collect your card. You know how much cards left back each year? I know my son came here in all the years that he didn't even pick up his card. So I know from how students can be. So you collect your card and you also read what are those benefits and keep them accountable, right? Because they will say something, we need to make sure that they honor it. Yes, that's our health center. When you come in, you will see the area desk there. That's the receptionist. We would urge you to go to her first, and then she will direct you, whether to appointments or so. And so one of the important functions of the health center also is to be able to provide the official medical certificate report. So if you are sick, and it was you missed a lecture or you missed some course activity, you don't need to come to the health center for that. You can get that sick leave from your doctor. That sick leave, though, has to come through to the health center for me to write that official medical excuse. Is that clear? It's come again. You are sick, you had some vomiting and diarrhea or so, you weren't able to do the course test, in-course test. You get your sick leave from your doctor, or if you came to the health center, the doctor there would give you that sick leave. But we would have to have some further information. There's a little course form that we will complete so that I have that information to know who I'm to send it to. I can't just send it to the dean. I have to send it also to the coordinator of that course so that they know for sure, yes, this person was really sick and they had to miss their class. All right? So that one, you can see outside, we send in the information, and that information you can send by that email. You don't even have to come in for that. Your health serves at umona.edu.jm. You send a proper copy of that form and the certificate. You know, people take pictures and we can't really use them, or they're just too expensive to print, so we rather PDF, your scan and PDF. If it is that you're unable to sit a final exam or unable to submit something that is going to be for your final grade, then what you need is not the same. The medicals, you might have gone to a doctor outside, that doctor needs to send me a medical report. That is information about the condition and so on. In fact, I would suggest to you, it is way easier and less convoluted if you are sick for an exam, if you can come to the health center or contact the health center, that's the best way forward. If you're actually in the exam and sick, the examiners are trained to know to escort you to the health center. If it is you were unable to get up that morning, you would need to come to us. You cannot tell me 3 days later that you were unable to get up. I have no proof of that, so I cannot write a medical excuse. This lady studied very hard at this university for many years, and she's not going to give up her my reputation. I do not sign or sell sick leaves, okay? I am doing the medical, I'm accountable to the university to see that this is indeed so. So you will complete, there is, let's just go to that. Online on the examination website, there is this form, medical certificate report. And so you will complete that legibly. We need to actually, we have made recommendations to add to this form because a telephone number is very useful to us. Many times people complete this, they did not send it through an email, and so we have no other way to contact the person. There's insufficient information on there. So always give us a contact number and answer the phone when we call you, because that's another thing. I call and I can hardly get students. I guess they don't. If they put you in the health center in your one of your recognized numbers, please. If the ID is not recorded, they don't answer their phone. And then when this is on that same form, this is Appendix A. Appendix B is the medical report, which your doctor will complete if you didn't see a doctor at the health center. And that has specific information. Doctors, like many of us, don't complete forms very well. And oftentimes, the diagnosis is so vague, I cannot give an excuse for vomiting. I have to have what is your diagnosis and what is the plan going forward and so on. So I also encourage you to let your doctors write legibly and give me their contact details, because I often have to call doctors to get information. But this information, your medical report, is your information between you and your doctor or the clinical director. Do not send your medical detail, medical reports to your coordinator, to your dean and so on. That's your personal information. They only need to know you are sick. You can send them your medical certificate. That's like a sick leave certificate to say how much days. Sure, send them that. But the report to say you have a brain tumor or you have endometriosis or whatever, that's your business and between doctor and them. When I do up that letter, when I review and see that yes, it is, as you would say, carpacetic, or that's an old word. No, I don't even know what is a new word. But once it's justified, then I'm going to write that letter to say, Tina Hilton, who had a medical condition and was unable to sit the exam, X, Y, and the code and the date and all of that. I have to have all of that information. I am not telling them that you had endometriosis or whatever. I just say medical condition. And that applies if it was you had a psychotic episode, I'm going to write medical condition. So that we keep your medical information confidential, all right? And I want you to know that at the health center, we are very respectful about confidentiality. And we have to, it's data protection laws now, right? And in addition, we have immunization services. It was out for a bit. I have some administrative hurdles to get through, but we are planning to continue it again. We were only given to the services to the medical faculty, nursing students and medical students, because they have to have chickenpox and hepatitis. But we're hoping to open this up to others so that you can pay whatever it is. And you see that last vaccine? Anybody know that vaccine? HPV, human papillomavirus. It is the most common STI, if we haven't got it already. But the vaccine can prevent it. And the Ministry of, we are hoping to access it from the Ministry of Health so that it will be much subsidized so that we can offer it to students as well at a cost. And I also note the SAGICOR says they will cover some of the cost. So please look, read up what is there on your services. Another new thing is that we have, in collaboration with Health Connect Jamaica, which is an organization which operates through University Faculty of Medical Sciences, they are trying to increase the access of care to HIV services. So persons with HIV can access private doctors through this Health Connect, or persons who want to prevent HIV can access oral testing, PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis, through this resource. It's just starting, so be a little patient with us, but I've put the picture there of Nurse Jacinth Moore, who works with Health Connect, who is our liaison. So you don't even necessarily have to come through the health center. We know sometimes you don't like to be up in your business, but we want you to know that these services are available and we can make that connection for you. So you would need to collect your health cards from SAS or wherever they say you are to collect it. And trust me, those files, sometimes if you don't get it, follow up with it. You should be able to get it. Sometimes it's actually misinformation you get, so make sure you get the information from the source. So as I said, you can walk in appointments. The dental clinic will do cleaning and education. We have dental therapists and dentists. And we can do pain management and so on. Anything that we cannot manage, sometimes where our resources are such, we will refer to polyclinic or elsewhere. But we know we get quite a bit from the students. And our pharmacy, as I said, they are really beefing up their supply, not only their pharmaceuticals, but also their over-the-counter. And when you look at the usage of our health insurance, the health center pharmacy is number two. Number one is down in Ligonie, and that's probably our lecturers. So we can fill all prescriptions and so on. And here's our WhatsApp. You can WhatsApp a prescription. Do not try to call them on that WhatsApp sign number. You can WhatsApp a prescription, they can say if they have it, and they can tell you when to collect it and what it will cost and all of that, so they can save your time. And we can provide advice. Also, we have contraception. We have the Depo-Provera injection, we have the pills, so we can also advise. And our nurse, who we have now, or in the main, I stole her from Hugh Winter Fertility Management Unit. In other words, we have another resource person as it relates to fertility management, contraception, and or infertility issues. And so their counseling services, we are always short because that is a big demand on our services, and understandably so. So we will urge you, and they do different promotions. The Faculty of Social Sciences have an excellent kind of promotion for mental health too. So I would say use your resources as well to promote and to prevent yourself from getting to the stage. That's, you know, it's very severe. But you can come in, we can make appointments and so on. At the moment, your appointments may take up to about a month, or and then follow up maybe a month to 6 weeks. Not ideal. We are, the ratio of counselors to students is quite low, but we are trying to improve that. And we have a psychiatrist and psychologist. We don't have Instagram yet, so don't follow us. This is our website, and it needs upgrading. We are really behind in this social age, but we are getting there, because most of the time we are trying to do all of the other things, and we don't have this kind of stuff, but we're really hoping, because communication is very important. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Doctor, for taking the time to speak to us today. It is very reassuring to know that our university cares about us excelling not only academically, but physically and mentally. So now, our next speaker is someone that holds the key to succeeding at UWE. One of these resources is the UWE Library. Yes, it's our extensive collection of resources to help us excel. And this speaker, Ms. Audrey Sadler, the librarian of the main library, is going to give us an overview of the resources available at the library. So ladies and gentlemen, once more, please help me welcome Ms. Sadler to the podium.
Good morning. I'm not sure if you can see the top of my head, but we will see. Yes, I'm trying to find a PowerPoint. Yes. So, good morning, Dean, Deputy Dean, other members of the platform, the associate deans, members of faculty, and most importantly, our students. Now, on behalf of the UWE Mona Library, I would like to welcome you to the UWI and to this new journey that you will begin. And as the moderator said, the library really makes a difference in the quality of your degree, in the quality of the resources that you will access. The main library is situated to the side. It is that blue building. So everybody who goes to KFC, I'm sure a lot of you are going to find your way to KFC at some point in time. If you just look across, you will see us. Those students who live on Taylor Hall are right across from us. And the main library is where a lot of you are going to make your home away from home, outside of your classes. There is the medical library on a hospital compound. So if you, for whatever reason, need a printed copy of a health resource, you would go across to the medical library. The law library houses a print law resources. And there is a science and engineering branch library in the Faculty of Sciences, which has the science-related resources. And if you happen to be in Mobay, you can go across to the Western Campus Jamaica Library. Now, all of the print resources for the social sciences are housed in the main library. There is a computer lab, a multifunctional room, the reprographic services unit, where we will print for you at a cost. We will also laminate, bind, photocopy, and most importantly, it has the overnight reading room, which is opened all through the weekend, and it is also opened until 6 a.m. during the course of the week. And as I heard your FSS rep speaking about studying in the library all night long, that is where students go, and they will sit there on a Saturday, on a Sunday, and right through the night until 6 o'clock in the morning. All print resources for the social sciences, whether it is econ, accounts, commerce, finance, etc., are kept in the main library, and we group them according to subject headings. Now we're in the electronic age, and so a lot of our resources are in electronic format. So when you look at our journal collections, all the journals that we subscribe to now, you will have to access them online. We also have databases, and we have electronic books. Some of the e-books, you're going to be looking at EBSCO, Springer, the UWI Press, and ProQuest. Now, when you think of SOSCI materials, these are the databases that you are going to use. ProQuest and EBSCO are the two most popular databases. They are what we call multidisciplinary. So if you do not use any other database, you will need to use ProQuest and EBSCO. We also have Emerald. There's a newspaper archives, which covers the first day that the Daily Gleaner was published. Until now, it is accessible online. And I'm going to recommend to you Credo, which is going to be a building block for all of your research programs. Your ID card is very, very important because it allows you access to the library as well as to borrow resources. Please ensure that at all times your password is current, because you are going to use your password to sign into UELink. UELink is a platform that allows you to access all our electronic resources. Once your password has expired, you will not be able to access UELink. And so for those of you who are at home, you're on the hall, you want to be able to download or read ebooks. You want to be able to access 15 pages of a journal article. Unless you are logged into UELink, you will not be able to do so. Now, what are some of the services that we offer? We lend resources, and we lend not only print resources, but we also lend laptops, we lend tablets. There is an information literacy component, and I'm going to encourage you to follow us on the different social media platforms, because it is very, very important that you participate in our information literacy programs. And so all of you are going to, if you already don't know what plagiarism is, you're going to learn the term, you're going to understand it, and you're going to ensure that at all times you maintain academic integrity while you are here. And when we talk about plagiarism, we're looking at taking someone else's work, whether it is an article, a paragraph from a book, even a sentence, something you may find on YouTube, some of you may find something on a blog, and attempt to pass it off as your own. There are penalties. The library will teach you how to avoid plagiarism by using the appropriate citation styles. How is it that you do your in-text citations? How is it that you prepare your references? And so pay careful attention to our sessions on plagiarism. We're going to be having them face-to-face, and all of them are going to be done on Zoom as well. So if you can't physically come to us, meet us on the Zoom platform. We are also going to be doing APA. For those of you who will be using APA, you must understand the rudiments of using APA. It is not a choice. And so come to us. We also do individual sessions. So if you want to come and sit with us at a reference desk, we will sit with you. If you want to join a session, if you want to come to us as a group, we will also do that. Research assistance is something that we also do. So if you're searching, the lecturer said you need 3 peer-reviewed articles. 1, you're not sure what a peer-reviewed article is. 2, you're searching and you cannot find anything. Come to us. We will also help you to find those resources. And so, as I said before, we will sit with you in person. You can contact us by phone. Our email addresses are there. We have instant messaging and, of course, WhatsApp. So, always remember that the library is there for you. You can access our resources at any time and any place. And we're basically open 24/7. Your UID is your passport to the library. And so at all times, we encourage you to use it. These are our opening hours, Mondays to Fridays. We are open from 8:30 to 10 p.m. On a Saturdays, we are open from 9:30 to 5 p.m. However, the overnight reading room will be opened once we are closed. Now, as we draw closer to exam, we tend to ramp up our opening hours. So on a Saturday, for example, we're usually staffed in the main library until 12 midnight. And on a Sunday, we're usually staffed from 12 noon until 8 p.m. I'm going to encourage you to participate in our UA Link training sessions. Our UA Link is the platform, the portal to access the UA Lab resources. And when we think of the UA Lab resources, we're not only thinking about Mona. We're thinking about Mona, Cave St. Augustine, an open campus. And so you need to understand, how is it that you are going to filter so that you are able to pull the resources that belong to Mona, especially those which are Mona owned resources. So beginning next week, we have UA Link sessions, Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays. We have them in the days. On a Tuesday and a Thursday, we have them at 6 o'clock in the evening. And Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, they are on Zoom. On a Saturday, we have a face-to-face session. So, on behalf of the library, once again, I want to say welcome. And I really want to congratulate you all on this new adventure. As you progress, you're going to be hearing more about the library. We're going to interface with all of you in your foundation critical reading and writing session, because there's a component of it that is taught by the library. And I'm going to encourage you all, get to know the library in your first semester. It really makes a difference, as I said, in the quality of your degree, in the quality of your presentations, your discussions, and in the quality of the assignments. We stand ready to work with you as you navigate your degree, and we wish you all the best. So I have one question to ask. It is a 3-part question. So, the first person who can come to the front and tell me how old the library is, what are 2 of the databases that you're going to use, and 1 of the services that we offer, I have a token for you. All 3 parts. How old is the library? And that should be fairly easy. What are two of the databases that I mentioned and one service? Good day. So how old is the library?
All right. Good day, everyone. Oh, sorry. All right. So UA is 75. So, of course, the library is 75.
Yes, no? Correct.
Yes. Two services that the library offers. They offer individual resource sessions for citing. That's one. Two, they offer, oh gosh, excuse me. What's the third part
of
the
question? Databases.
Two databases is the UE Link and the. UE Link
is a portal.
UE Link is a portal?
To access the databases.
Oh gosh. The two popular databases are the UE Link.
No.
No. I remember it, you know.
All right, so since she was brave enough to come, and if you notice, she did say that the library is 75 years old, and that really underscores the importance of the library, because you cannot have a university without a library. And so the two databases are ProQuest and EBSCO. So here is a token. Always think of the library. And she says she's going to be living there, and believe you me, we have students who live in the library. So if you see me on the corridor, just say hi and gently remind me that you are an FSS student and we're good to go. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Sadler, for that wonderful presentation. Okay. One second. So when you see the brown bag, it means we have our next spot prize. So we have two prizes back to back. However, before we go to the spot prize, you know, we need to sprinkle a bit of information. So, just for you to know, today, as our dean has told us, the University of the West Indies is ranked number one in the Caribbean. And the UE has five campuses, Mona in Jamaica, St. Augustine in Trinidad and Tobago. Now we have some Trinidadians here, woot woot. And we also have Cahill in Barbados. Yes, rep your country, rep your country. Cahill in Barbados, the five islands in Antigua and Barbuda, and the global campus, as well as 10 global centers in partnership with universities in North America, Latin America, Asia, Africa, Europe, everywhere. And every year, thousands of students choose to study at UE. So you all are privileged to be here. So once again, give yourself a round of applause for being smart students. Awesome. So now, for the spot prize. For this question, I want you guys to give a very deep and thoughtful answer. So here's the question. Why did you choose UE as your place to shine? First person. You have to come up. No, raise your hands.
Hi. I chose UE, specifically Mona, because I wanted to experience life in Jamaica and life overseas, but just because of the legacy of the school and what I wanted to study. So yeah, that's what I chose.
Give a round of applause, people. And which country are you from?
Barbados.
All right, so here you go. Good, congrats. Okay. Now to our next speaker. So many of you know FSS is a faculty unlike others that likes intellectual curiosity, and it likes when you explore in other areas. Me, myself, I have a minor in a different faculty. And thankfully, the FSS programs include opportunities to pursue free electives and minors after completing the core courses four-year degree program. Our next speaker is Dr. Nicole Plummer from the Faculty of Humanities and Education, who will give us an overview of possible free electives and minors available in that faculty. So ladies and gentlemen, give her a warm round of applause.
Thank you. All right, good morning, everyone. I'm just gonna try and find, here we are. So I was during my undergraduate years, I met Dr. Heather Ricketts, right? So if there's a cross-fertilization between the Faculty of Humanities and Education and the Faculty of Social Sciences. And this cross-fertilization really helped me to develop as a student. Okay, sorry about that. Now, our faculty is one of the vibrant faculties, probably not, you know, as vibes as Faculty of Social Sciences, right? Because, you know, I know where I am right now. You know, and when you speak in people house, you must speak wonderfully about them. Right? So thank you for this opportunity. No, we're not just a place where you have to do your writing courses, because I know some of you are saying to yourself, Lord, geez, may I have writing for though. And we're not just a place where you have to do Caribbean civilization. And we're not just that place where you have to do your foreign language requirements. We offer so much more. And I'm here to talk to you very briefly about that so much more, because I can read a room and I know I'm not hot, tired, I won't get out of here, right? So I'll make it short. So we have 8 different departments and faculties. I'm not gonna read them out. We have the popular Caribbean School of Media and Communication. I was a history major based in the Department of History and Archaeology. I'm now a lecturer in the Institute of Caribbean Studies. And if you're wondering about the meaning of the world and things like sex, sexuality and philosophy, or about business ethics, then you might be interested in philosophy. Now, there's also language and information studies. That's where you go to learn how to use the internet, how to use information. Because we live in an information age where people don't know how to use information. Yes, it's true. For those of you interested in writing, drama, stage production, then literatures in English might very well be for you in terms of minors. And foreign language, that is definitely the modern languages and literatures. Now, if you want to do a little bit dabbling education, there's a School of Education. Now, we have a wide range of electives. Today, when I was preparing the presentation, I said, oh my God, I cannot list out all these electives. So I did you one better. I'm taking you now to our faculty handbook. All right, I'm hoping, okay. So this wonderful, wonderful Wi-Fi. So if you go to the UEMONA and you go to HUMED, or just type in Humanities and Education, go to the section that has handbooks. In the table of contents, you're going to see the various departments and, of course, the various courses. There are tons of courses. I can't list them off, and I can't privilege one department over the other that we have in my head. So when you go there, for those of you who are level 1 or level 2, if you're, and I hear that in the Faculty of Social Sciences, you do your core courses first. So if you want to, and you need level 1 electives, you just go to level 1. If it is that there's a specific minor, we're going to come to that shortly, that you want to do, then you focus on using your elective spaces to do the minors. Now, how many of you, I hear saying elective, elective, elective. How many of you know what I mean by elective? All right, so let me just backtrack a little bit there. You have, if you're doing, say, a major in government, there are some core courses, the Gov 1000, 1001, yes, I know the courses, 1008, same thing with psychology, and they all have these codes. And they're supposed to be the courses that you must do to get your major, right? Now you're going to see a space that sometimes says elective or a space that is blank, or you're registering, your program has courses listed out, several, say 8 government courses, and then you just say 2, 3. Because each full-time student does 5 courses per semester. Now 3 of those 5 courses may count towards your major. What do you do with the other 2? That is where the electives come in. Am I making sense here? So then you decide now to become the well-rounded scholar that UWE wants you to be. Now, while I'm telling you about my faculty, there are other faculties, of course, like the Faculty of Science and Technology. But you can go ahead and do a level 1 elective if you need a level 1 elective, a level 2 elective. And you know, 1 from 2, of course, is because if you're doing psychology, then it would be Psych 1000 for level 1, Psych 2000 for level 2. And the same thing with our courses as well. You would look up for that. And you do what it is that you want to do, because we offer courses in graphic design, photography, event planning, entertainment management. Yes, you never thought that humanities do all them vibes of things, not true? You never thought it. And if you're already working and you want to communicate effectively with your boss, then you might want to look at workplace communication and strategy. I teach a course in food culture, for example. Yes, there's a culture of food. You ever wonder why you eat what you eat? Yes, there's that. We have gender, music, and culture. We have Rastafari culture. And yes, I'm privileged in my department, yes, because I know the programs very well. But if you're interested in public relations, we actually have that. If you want to know about philosophy, especially if you're moving into politics and you want to know how the world turns, and if you want to know language and how language operates, then linguistics is for you. So again, go to the Faculty of Humanities and Education. The handbook is there. Download the handbook, have it there. Look at the minors, look at the offerings. Because you can do little courses like me. I did marketing, I did sociology. I did quite a few courses over the Faculty of Social Sciences when I was an undergrad student. But I didn't do a minor. Other students of mine did history and a minor. So what are minors? Very often, minors require 5 courses at levels 2 and 3, excluding the level 1 qualifying courses. So always look out for the level 1 courses. So we offer minors in creative writing, minors in Japanese, and I know Japan taking off for many of you with animation. We offer minors geography, language, literature, writing, entertainment and cultural enterprise management, journalism, you name it, we have it. We are the place where you learn to write, to think, critical thinking skills. And if you want a place, small tutorials, individualized attention, development of yourself, that is us. And so I end here. See, I made it short.
Thank you, Dr. Flamo, for such a sweet and short presentation. Okay, I keep forgetting our spot prize. So, we have our brown bag. One last spot prize. So before we go there, as we've been drumming it into your head. So we've been drumming it into your head that FSS is the vibesy faculty. And as such, you know, we have to be very balanced, not only academic, but you know, we are encouraged to get involved in co-curricular activities, and there are many opportunities on halls. We have Taylor Hall here. Make some noise, Taylor. Hey, great. And also clubs and societies to further develop your skills and interests. And every Thursday afternoon between 2 and 5 p.m., classes pause to allow students to participate in these activities, covering areas ranging from sports to arts to culture to religion, career advancements, the academics such as the Honor Society, and as well as, you know, other great, invigorating, engaging clubs that can help you develop as a human being. UWE also has activities for everyone, regardless of your interests. Now it's time for this third spot prize. So I have a small token for the first person who comes up here and tells us what are the co-curricular plans you have while at UWE. So any first person to come up here. All right, Taylor. Good, good, good.
I am planning on joining Circle K while I am at UWE. While going to high school, I was a part of Key Club, and I decided I want to continue that journey, so I want to try Circle K because of that.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Give her a round of applause. Congrats. Great answer. Okay, so now we're going to our next speaker, very important speaker. By show of hands, show me who has paid their UWE tuition already. Okay, didn't take notes. Okay, well, another area of critical importance is our finances. And now we have Miss Kimberly Henry, who is the customer service officer in the bursary and student administration services section. And she's here to tell us all about money, money, money. So money matters, tuition, fee, payments. So ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Miss Henry to the podium.
Good afternoon, everyone. I know it's ending, but I need a little more, you know? Good afternoon, everyone. All right, so I don't want you to be scared because we'll be talking about money. But at the end of the day, I'm here to help you prepare for your tertiary level education and to try to make it as easy as possible, all right? So how many persons are a bit timid, are a bit questionable about how they're going to go about financing their tertiary level education? Everybody, right? Now, what I want to say is that the University of the West Indies has one of the most competitive rates, maybe internationally. And we are here to help you, to guide you through, to see what are the steps you can take to finance your way through the tertiary level education. So as earlier mentioned, my name is Kimberly Henry, and I'm proudly representing the bursary department here today, specifically SAS, Student Administrative Services Section, as well as our twin office, the Billings and Receivables Section. So before I go any further, I just want to clear up a little misconception. Now, SAS, the office, is not one and the same as SAS, the website. Now you have SAS, which is Student Administration System. That's where most of you went to do your registration and if you need to do any adjustments to your registration and so forth. SASS, Student Administrative Services Section, is a subsection of the bursary. So any financial queries that you might have throughout your journey here, SAS, SASS, is the persons that you need to know. SAS is the office that you need to engage if you have any questions about your finances. If you're expecting funding from any scholarships, any donors, if you made payments anywhere and not seen it on your statement of accounts, nobody say UET if your money, come to SAS so SAS can help you to resolve your matter. All right? We get that? Now, on to the commitment fee. I see some persons raise their hand that they paid the tuition. But for those who have not yet paid the tuition, everybody else paid the commitment fee? I like that. I like that. And accepted the offer. Now, the commitment fee is a deposit that you've made to the institution. And if you have not yet made the payment and you're kind of shy not to say that, I'm just letting you know that it's not too late. All right? Because this is you communicating your commitment to the institution to participate, to be enrolled here. Now, it's not a case that you're paying $20,000 to UWE and UWE just take your money. All right? It's not like that. It's a case where in which you're depositing $20,000 to your student account and that can be used to offset any future charges that might be applied to your account. So for example, in the future when you register, if you've not yet registered, you will see where things like your miscellaneous fees are applied to your account. It can be used towards that. Now, one thing I want to make mention of about the commitment fee is that it is non-refundable. So it cannot be claimed once you have made payment to the institution. So at any given time, there are three main charges that a student can anticipate to be added to their student account. So naturally, you can expect for tuition to be applied to your account. So tuition, the charge that is applied to your account is dependent on your program of study. Things, for example, as whether you're full-time or part-time also plays an important role to determine the charge that is applied to your account. Your nationality as well might also play a role to determine what charge is applied to your account. Miscellaneous fees. This is a compulsory fee. So once you're registered at the institution, whether it is your first time in semester one or semester two, just know that miscellaneous fees are compulsory. Now, payment of your miscellaneous fees open the gate to other facilities that are on campus. So as earlier mentioned, you can seek health care, you can seek counseling, dental care, that are services offered by the health center. But you can also utilize services that are offered by the library by making the payment of your miscellaneous fees. Now, the miscellaneous fee that is applied to your account is dependent on whether or not you're living on campus or off campus. But of course, we'll get to that in a bit. Another charge that you can anticipate as a student would be a residence charge. So naturally, if you're not living on a hall, then you should not be charged for resident. Not true? Right? So if you're living on a hall, then this charge will be applicable to you. So the charge that is applied to your account for housing is dependent on the hall on which you reside. Now, regrettably, SAS or the bursary, we do not show a statement of accounts for our 138 student living operation. So for example, the Irving Halls, the Georgia Lanes, and so forth. Because you make payment to 138 directly if you're living on any one of those halls. But for the traditional halls and the Mona operated halls, so for example, Taylor, I'm a Taylor, right? Hello. All right. And if we have any chancellor persons in here, Mary Seacole, those type of halls, we will be here to apply the statement, the charges to your statement of accounts, so you will see that there, all right? So how do you find the fees? I've mentioned tuition, I've mentioned the miscellaneous fee, and I've mentioned the residence. All of this information is available to you online. So from any search engine, you can go ahead and type in UE check fees, and it's usually the first link that is populated in the results. And you'll be taken to an interface that looks like this. So it is dependent on the information that you're looking for, will naturally say which link that you choose. So if you want to see the information for tuition, you go ahead and click the link that is for tuition or for residence or for miscellaneous fees, you name it. But we also make it easy for you, for those persons who want to use e-commerce to make payments, that you can use the option here to pay fees online. So it's basically like a one-stop link. You know what it is? All right, you can go ahead and make payments now. So for the social science faculty, undergraduate level, when you go to the tuition fee sheet, this is the area of the fee sheet that you are interested in to know what tuition you should anticipate. Now, if you are doing any programs that are not explicitly listed here, so for example, the one that is listed is political leadership management and strategy. So for example, if you're doing anything like accounts, econ, what else? Sociology, I'm not sure of all the programs. But if you're not seeing it being listed on the fee sheet, then naturally the fee that is applicable to you is that in the first row. So if you're a Jamaican national, then the fee that is applicable to you is, as a full-time student, $325,000 and change. But if you're a part-time student, you're billed per credit, and that is $10,846 per credit. The miscellaneous fees, as mentioned earlier, it is dependent on whether or not you're living on hall or if you're traveling to school. So if you're living on hall, it is $38,937 for the year, you only pay this once. But if you're commuting, then it is $30,437, and this includes the cost of your ID card. So if you've made the payment of the miscellaneous fees and you need to go and take your ID picture but you lost the receipt, you can come to SAS and we can give you that information. We can give you a slip to send or to use as your support. So where can you make your payments? The fastest options would be to come to the bursar cashier, which is located in the annex building there, or to make the payment via e-commerce. Now, as mentioned earlier, the payments made via e-commerce reflects on your account same time, such as with payments made at the bursar cashier. Other options include Paymaster, Western Union, Bill Express, you name it. But if you also bank with NCB, you can use the bill payment option that is available with NCB. Or you can go in and use a full service teller and make payments there. So payments made outside of the e-commerce platform can take up to 24 to 48 hours to be reflected on your account. So for the e-commerce platform, I'm not sure if anyone has used this platform before. However, if you want to make payment there, then you just go ahead and you create an account or you log in. Sign in, log in, register your card, and then you make payments. But if you have any questions as to how to navigate the website, how to know which cards you can use, which currency is acceptable, then there's a manual there available for you as well. Now, all fees for semester one, residence, tuition, and miscellaneous fees, they are due by September 1st, and for semester two, it is due by January 12th. So if you've are not able to make the payment in full by the stipulated deadline, then you can anticipate or take advantage, rather, of the installment plans that are available. So we have installment plans available for tuition as well as for residence. For the tuition installment plan, you need to make sure that the miscellaneous fee is paid in its entirety. You also need to make sure that you're fully registered and you pay a deposit of 25% of the tuition. For the residence, you need to also make sure that the miscellaneous fee is paid, but also that the charge for residence is on your account and that you've also made the payment of this 25%. It is a service that is available for you online. So the Bursar Online Student System, aka BOSS, this is where you will need to go. The installment plan is already open, but the deadline to apply for the plan will be September 15th. So you have up until September 15th to try to get yourself on a plan. Because once you go ahead and register, it means that you're financially obligated to cover your fees. You cannot sit an assessment, you cannot sit an examination with fees outstanding. And I say that to say that there are some penalties that might be enforced if you do not fulfill your financial obligation with the institution. So the first thing is that you will see where late fines are populated, they are generated and applied to your account. They will continue to be applied to your account until your account itself is regularized. You need to ensure that you are financially cleared so that there are no holds that are applied to your account, which will further restrict your ability to sit any exams, to utilize any services that are available on campus as well. You will not be able to see any grades with a financial hold on your account. And you will also, for the extremely delinquent accounts, be sent to a collection agency. The university has the right to do so. So if you've owed the institution, if you're in our arrears for an extensive period of time, I'm afraid I have to say that you will be sent to a collection agency or your information will be transferred to the credit bureau. So I mentioned earlier the Bursar Online Student System. So I just want to introduce you to it because there are some services that you can request for online without the need to come in office. That does not say that we don't want to see you. If you need to come, please come. So if you are using any search engine, just type in UE Online Systems under the section for students, click on the link for BOSS, and you'll be able to sign in using your credentials, which is your ID number and your password. You can utilize services, for example, requesting a tuition letter to see your unofficial statement of accounts, to request installment plans, just to name a few. So I'm closing out, but I want to inform you all that the proxy authorization, which is also a form available online, is also important. Now, this is important because I'm sure that most of you are used to mommy and daddy doing business on your behalf. Now, at this stage, at this level of your education, you are considered to be our client. You are considered to be our legal client. So if you're sending anyone, mommy, daddy, auntie, a friend, anyone outside of yourself to represent you, to collect any documents from SAS, then you need to make sure that this is communicated to us so we can assist. Failure to do so will result in us not being able to give any information about your account. We need to make sure that we uphold your credibility. So if you have any questions, anything that I did not touch on, but you or you need for us to expound on anything, reach out to us on weekdays at 8:30 to 4:30. We're available on WhatsApp, chats only, so 876-280-8238. Or you can contact us directly by phone at 876-618-5066 or email customer.services@uemona.edu.jm. So again, welcome to the UWE Pelican family. I hope your journey here will be a very rewarding one. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Ms. Henry. Because of you, I'm sure everybody here today will not have any holds on their accounts. All right, so now we have, for your safety is important on campus. In addition to calling campus security and the Mona Police Post for help, students have the option of downloading the Rush Alert app to your phones. So please watch this short video to learn more about the Rush Alert, which was developed by a team right here in the VibeZ Faculty of Social Sciences. So, yes, we hope you play.
Danger can strike when you least expect it. But what if you could carry safety in the palm of your hand? Meet the Rush Alert Panic Button, the game changer in personal safety. Imagine having the power to summon help with a double tap. No more feeling vulnerable while in transit. Whether you're exploring new places or just getting around, Rush Alert keeps you safe. The world is yours to explore without hesitation. Ready for a safer journey? Or ready to order your panic button? Discover more at rushalertservices.com or follow us on IG at Rush Alert Limited for exclusive updates. Rush Alert, keeping you safer one notification at a time. You can download the Rush Alert app from the Google Play Store and Apple App Store.
Wonderful. You see what the faculty produces, guys? And that could be you next year. Who knows in the future? So, yes. Okay. So, thank you for your patience. We're winding down now. But before you all leave, we have a quick, short little activity from our FSS representative. So, Perry.
I just want to give away two things, all right? For the student that can come and tell me at least three of the departments under the Faculty of Social Sciences, you get a lash and bag. A joke, just the bag, just the bag. All right, and I have something else. Somebody was coming, oh God. All right, I have two, come, tell her to come. Come man, come. And they must tell us which department they are from. So come.
Good morning, everybody. Three departments under the Faculties of Social Sciences are Government, Management, MSBM, and Humanities. Humanities and Education. Economics.
Okay. All right. I'm going to give her a pass. But don't mention Humanities again.
Sorry.
Give her a round of applause. And what the... You have warm to your voice. Taylor, take it away. She's from, what is it? Econ Department of MSBM. Big up all of the MSBM people, let me know how. All right. I would like for you to tell me, this is probably too easy. What is the name, or what are the names of our dean and deputy dean? And remember the titles. You will get an ID string. You need to secure your IDs. It gives you access to the library. You don't want to lose it. This is a very important prize. All right, we have somebody from Taylor coming. Are Taylor this?
Yes.
Okay.
Dr. Heather Ricketts, which is the dean, and Dr. Christine Clark, deputy dean.
And what is my name? What is my name? You're right, that dog.
Awesome. Thank you, Ferry, for that activity. All right. So, thank you all for your patience once more. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of today's program. But before you go, let me remind you about the upcoming department welcome ceremonies, because as the deputy dean emphasized, you need to know your department, and these orientations are very, very important. So tomorrow, Tuesday, August 29th at 9 a.m., we have MSBM Social Sciences at the Social Sciences Lecture Theater, which is right there, very close by, as well as the Department of Economics, which is at the I-102 Alistair McIntyre Complex. And then on Wednesday, August 30, we have the Department of Government at 9 a.m. at the Social Sciences Lecture Theater. And at 1 p.m., we have the Department of Sociology, Psychology, and Social Work at the Social Sciences Lecture Theater. Also, remember to visit the FSS website and follow the FSS social media handles for the latest updates. I would like to thank our amazing presenters, Dr. Ricketts, Dr. Clark, Dr. Hilton Kong, Ms. Sadler, Ms. Henry, Mr. Perry Cummings. Thank you for all the information and entertainment. And thank you all for coming out and being attentive and answering questions. You're all a great audience. And lastly, as a Grace Scholar, I want to thank Grace for being here, for their sponsorship of today's event. I know, amazing corporation. And now I invite you all to visit the GK booth as you leave. Walk good. Bye, everyone.